This is Alan Bell, for the record, the Development Services Department. So, Chair and members of the Commission, very grateful that you're here tonight. We've got all three of our Commission members here to make a quorum. The image on the screen identifies the vicinity of the proposed True by Hilton Hotel. You see Curragh Hollow Road running north-south through the site. Grantline Road is left and right with Interstate 205 shown across the top of the image. Right at the northwest corner of Curragh Hollow Road and Grantline Road is the existing Home2 Suites Hotel that was built in 2020, also by the same owner proposing this True by Hilton, represented by Andy Kotecha, who's here with us tonight. The Home2 Suites site and the business has been very successful there. They've been able to acquire an interest in the adjacent property to the north that's outlined in the yellow highlight, that rectangular-shaped property, about the same size, almost 2 acres, as the Home2 Suites site is where the True by Hilton site is proposed. You can see from this image, it illustrates fairly well the growing, developing commercial vicinity to the north, west, and south of the hotel site. It's got good visibility to the freeway and certainly very good access to Interstate 205 and in the residential neighborhood across Curragh Hollow Road to the east. The hotel is proposed to a very similar scale and massing as the Home2 Suites site, which we'll get to in just a second. It's got proposed to have 78 rooms, less than 50 feet tall, 4 stories, a pool outside on the north side. So the next image is a site plan that's showing both the proposed True by Hilton on the upper side of this image and then the existing Home2 Suites Hotel on the lower portion of this image, with Curragh Hollow Road over on the right side at the east and Grantline Road at the bottom of this image. This site plan illustrates how the project is consistent with city standards with respect to the number of parking spaces and dimensional requirements for drive aisles and parking spaces, landscaping, utility connections, sewer storm and water analyses were performed, as well as a roadway study documenting compliance with city standards and connection requirements. Circulation for the site, access to the proposed True by Hilton will be indirectly to Curragh Hollow Road and Grantline Road through the Home2 Suites site. There are two-way driveways proposed for the True by Hilton site, both on the south property line, one along the east side by Curragh Hollow Road, and one on the west end of the site. So those are the two driveways to access True by Hilton through the Home2 Suites site. There are also a couple of three proposed potential connections to the north and to the west, the adjacent property, if there are compatible uses that could benefit from efficiencies or conveniences to access to the north for customers or employees, deliveries, and so forth. Those potential access points are identified on the site plan here, and something that the city expects, and the property owner has been participating with that vision of potential connections to adjacent property. So the next image identifies the exterior building elevations. These are the four sides of the proposed hotel. We can see it's a modern contemporary architecture, providing interest and variety with a variety of colors and vertical and horizontal relief on the four elevations of the building, with a substantial cover over the front, the south side of the hotel, for loading and unloading and identifying the strong identification for the entrance to the hotel. So those are the four sides of the hotel. So like we said, similar in scale to the Home2 Suites. This is actually a bit shorter, just with its decorative parapet wall height, maybe 10 feet or so shorter than the highest point of the adjacent Home2 Suites hotel. So the hotel proposal would be considered and reviewed by the Planning Commission through the Development Review Permit. That's the permit through which we look at the architecture and site plan, parking and utility connections and so forth. This project also includes a proposed general plan amendment to amend the general plan designation of this 2-acre site from office to commercial. The image on the screen has two illustrations. The top one, They're both general plan designations, just an excerpt from the general plan map. The top one shows the office designation in green, red color is for commercial, and then on the east side of Corral Hollow Road, we've got some tan and yellow colors identifying residential zoning. So right at the northwest corner of Corral Hollow and Grantline Roads, we've got the Home2 Suites site, which is red. And on the upper image, that site kind of lightly outlined in yellow, where the True by Hilton is proposed, we can see the difference between the upper and lower images. The upper one, it shows it green for office, and at the bottom one, it's red for commercial. So the commercial general plan designation is proposed for this site because the office general plan designation does not provide for hotels. When the city evaluated, and ultimately the city council approved this office general plan designation for this vicinity in 2006. We already had the Kaiser Medical Office building on the north side of Grantline Road had just opened. We had the Sutter office building, which later was sold. It's still a medical office building adjacent to the Home2 Suites to the west. This developing office area, the city council saw a vision and an opportunity to encourage that type of development, and hence came the office general plan designation. We believe that this hotel is consistent with the consumer and the consumer service focus of this area and compatible with the land uses in the vicinity. And it supports the developing nature of this vicinity. And therefore, we support the general plan designation change from office to commercial to accommodate the proposed True by Hilton Hotel. The zoning of the site on both sides of Grantline Road, west of Corral Hollow Road, is general highway commercial, a designation that's fairly broad in what it allows, and it does allow hotels as well as offices, and that is not proposed, and it would not need to be changed with this project. The CEQA review for this project is an initial study mitigated negative declaration. This documentation is required because of the general plan amendment that's part of the project. It's just a function of CEQA that it's not something that could be exempt, and so that initial study was performed. The mitigated negative declaration was prepared, it was published, it was noticed, and it's attached to this staff report in its final form as it was published, and that, along with the general plan designation change and development review permit, is recommended that you recommend that the City Council adopt the mitigated negative declaration tonight as well. That's the third item of the three actions for this project. So with us tonight, we have Majid Mohammed with the Engineering Division up here at the staff table. He oversaw the city's review of the upcoming grading permits and utilities and frontage improvements and all the things related to the public right-of-way. Also joining us currently via WebEx are Frederick Ventner and Colin Ogilvy. They're both with Kimley Horn Associates. They oversaw the preparation and review of the traffic analysis for the project. Elise Laws is also joining us currently by WebEx. She's with the Novo Planning Group. They prepared the CEQA documentation for the project. And just to make it clear and quick for you, we've got, we in the audience, we're honored to have Andy Kotecha with the Rad Hospitality Group, owner developer of the hotel, and David Burkett with, he's the architect with Red Inc. Architects for the project, are available to answer questions or maybe have some words for you. So that concludes our presentation, and staff recommends that the Planning Commission recommend that the City Council approve this project for the True by Hilton Hotel. And that concludes our report, Chair. Thank you.